Hello friends, I am Professor Yogesh Chaba from Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar, Haryana. In this lecture, we will study about firewall. First of all, please see the contents which I shall cover. After covering brief introduction about firewall, I shall take up different types of firewall, which will be followed by detailed architecture of firewall. The ability to connect any computer anywhere to any other computer anywhere is a mixed blessing. For individuals at home, wandering around the internet is a great fun. For corporate security managers, it is a nightmare. Most companies have large amounts of online confidential information, trade secrets, product development plans, marketing strategies, financial analysis, and many more. Disclosure of this information to a competitor can have dire consequences. In addition to the danger of information leaking out, there is also a danger of information leaking in. In order to solve this problem, we definitely require a system that monitors and controls the incoming and outgoing network traffic in any organization. Such system is called firewall. A firewall typically establishes a barrier between a trusted, secure internal network and untrusted outside network such as the internet that is assumed not to be secure or trusted. Firewalls are often characterized as either network firewalls or host-based firewalls. Network firewalls are software or hardware-based systems that filter traffic between two or more networks. Host-based firewalls provide a layer of software on one host that controls network traffic in and out of any single machine. The term firewall originally referred to as a wall, intended to confine a fire or potential fire within a building. This term firewall is now used for protection system which protects computers or networks from intruders or attackers. Figure shows an example of firewall installed between a LAN and a WAN. For a firewall to be effective, any organization first need to define their network security policy. A network security policy identifies the resources that need protection and the threats against them. It then defines how they can be used and who can use them. It also stipulates the actions to be taken when the policies are violated. The firewall is responsible for filtering traffic according to the security policy. Now, let us see different generations of firewall. First generation of firewall is packet filter or stateless firewalls. This type of firewall called packet filter looks at network addresses and ports of the packet and determines if that packet should be allowed or blocked. Packet filters act by inspecting the packets which are transferred between computers on the internet. If a packet does not match the packet filter set of filtering rules, the packet filter will drop or silently discard the packet or reject it. Conversely, if the packet matches one or more of the programmed filter, the packet is allowed to pass. This type of packet filtering pays no attention to whether a packet is part of an existing system of traffic or not. In other words, we can say that it stores no information on connection state. Packet filtering firewalls work mainly on the first three layers of the OSI reference model, which means most of the work is done between the network and physical layers, with a little bit of peeking into the transport layer to figure out source and destination port numbers. Coming on to second generation of firewall, that is stateful filters. Second generation firewalls perform the work of their first generation predecessor, but operate up to layer 4, that is transport layer of the OSI model. This is achieved by retaining packets until enough information is available to make a judgment about its state. Known as stateful packet inspection, it records all connections passing through it and determines whether a packet is the start of a new connection, a part of an existing connection, or it is not part of any connection. Static rules are used which contain connection state as one of their test criteria. Last generation of firewall is third generation, which is application firewall. The key benefit of application layer filtering is that it can understand certain applications and protocols such as file transfer protocol FTP, domain name system DNS, or hypertext transfer protocol HTTP. Application layer firewalls work on the application level of the TCP/IP stack and may intercept all packets traveling to or from an application. Application firewalls function by determining whether a process should accept any given connection or not. Application firewalls accomplish their function by hooking into socket calls to filter the connections between the application layer and the lower layers of the OSI model. Application firewalls that hook into socket calls are also referred to as socket filters. Application firewalls work much like a packet filter, but application filters apply filtering rules on per process basis instead of filtering connections on per port basis. It is rare to find application firewalls not combined or used in conjunction with a packet filter. Let us see different types of firewalls. Firewalls can be classified into three basic categories: packet filters, proxy servers, which include application gateways and circuit level gateways, and stateful packet filters. There is also a fourth category, that is hybrid of three main categories. For example, a firewall may be a combination of the application gateway and packet filter, or a proxy server and a stateful packet filter. Figure illustrates the different types of firewalls. Now, let us see first type of firewall, that is packet filter. A packet filter is a firewall that inspects each packet for user-defined filtering rules to determine whether to pass or block it. Packet filtering is looking at the headers in network packets and deciding whether or not to allow the packet based on the policy enforced by the firewall. Packet filters use one or more of the following parameters to make their decision whether or not to forward the packet. These parameters are source address, destination address, network header, transport level protocol, that is TCP, UDP or ICMP, flags in the transport header, options in the transport header, source or destination port, the interface on which the packet was received or will be sent, and whether the packet is inbound or outbound. For example, the filtering rule might require all telnet requests to be dropped. Using this information, the firewall will block all packets that have a port number 23, which is the default port number for telnet. Packet filters are fast and can be easily implemented in existing routers. Although packet filtering is fast, unfortunately, they are the least secure of all firewalls and they have some drawbacks. One disadvantage of packet filter is that they have no logging facility that can be used to detect whether a break-in has occurred. Also, a packet filtering firewall grants or denies access to the network according to the source and destination addresses or ports. Unfortunately, these ports can be spoofed. As a result, anyone can access network resources once access has been granted to an authorized user. Another problem is the difficulty of writing correct filters. Further drawback is that packet filtering cannot identify which user is causing which network traffic. It can inspect the IP address of the host from which the traffic originates, but by determining a host, user cannot be always identified. Next type of firewall are proxy servers. A proxy service is an application that redirects users' request to the actual services based on an organization's security policy. All communication between a user and the actual server occurs through the proxy server. Thus, a proxy server acts as an communication broker between clients and the actual application servers. Proxy servers can operate at either the application layer or the transport layer. Thus, there are two classes of proxy servers: application gateways, which operate at the application layer, and circuit level gateways, which operate on the transport layer. Application gateways. An application gateway is a proxy server that provides access control at the application layer. It acts as an application layer gateway between the protected network and the untrusted network. Because it operates at the application layer, it is able to examine traffic in detail and therefore is considered the most secure type of firewall. It can prevent certain applications such as FTP from entering the protected network. It can also log all network activities according to applications for both accounting and security audit purposes. Application gateways can also hide information. Since all requests for services in the protected network pass through the application gateway, it can provide network address translation or IP address hiding functionality. It can conceal IP addresses in the protected network from the internet by replacing the IP addresses of every outbound packet, that is packets going from the protected network to the internet with its own IP address. Next type of proxy firewall is circuit level gateways. A circuit level gateway is a proxy server that validates TCP and UDP sessions before allowing a connection or circuit through the firewall. It is actively involved in the connection establishment and it does not allow packets to be forwarded until the necessary access control rules have been satisfied. A circuit level gateway is not as secure as an application gateway because it validates TCP and UDP sessions without full knowledge of the applications that use these transport services. Moreover, once a session has been established, any application can run across that connection. Now, let us see stateful packet filters. Although the application gateway provides the best security among the preceding firewalls, but unfortunately, its intensive processing requirement slows down network performance. A stateful packet filtering gateway attempts to provide tight security without compromising performance. Unlike the application gateway, it checks the data that passes through the network layer but does not process it. The firewall maintains state information for each session, where session state include a combination of communication phase and the endpoint application state. Now, we will see firewall architecture. Firewall architecture refers to the manner in which firewall components are arranged to provide effective protection against unauthorized users. It is usually defined after the network security policy has been defined because it is supposed to be a model that enforces the security policy. The network security policy is enforced at defensible boundaries within the network, and these boundaries are called perimeter networks. A corporate network usually contains multiple perimeter networks that can be classified into three groups. The outermost perimeter network, one or more internal perimeter network, and the innermost perimeter network. The outermost perimeter network provides a boundary between private resources and external resources. internal perimeter network represent boundaries within the corporate network that need additional security. Now, we will discuss the three most commonly used firewall architectures. First is dual homes host firewall, screened host firewall and screened subnet firewall. First, let us see dual homed host firewall architecture. A dual homed host firewall is a type of the multi-homed host firewall. In the dual homed host firewall, the host which provides the firewall functionality has two interfaces. One interface is connected to the private network and the other interface is connected to the internet. Thus, all IP traffic from the internet must pass through the dual homed host firewall before arriving at a host in the private or corporate network. Similarly, an internal host can communicate with the external host or internet via the dual homed host firewall. Direct communication that bypasses the dual homed host is blocked. This means that the IP forwarding capability of the dual homed host is disabled to ensure that IP packets from one network are not directly routed to the other network. The dual homed host cannot operate as a router. However, disabling IP packet forwarding ensures that the internet and the private corporate network are logically disconnected so that even when system problems occur, the firewall cannot fail open. Second type of firewall architecture is screened host firewall. Unlike the dual homed host firewall architecture, which allows the host firewall to be connected to two networks, the screened host firewall architecture allows the host providing the firewall, called a Boston host, to connect only to the private network. A separate screening router is placed between the host and the internet. Thus, the screened host firewall is a combination of a packet filtering router and an application gateway. The screening router performs a packet filtering function and is configured so that the Boston host is the only host in the private network that can be accessed from the internet. The screening router may be configured to permit or block connections between internal host and the internet. Its basic function is to filter traffic classes that have been defined as security risk in the security policy before they arrive at the Boston and other internal host. Since the Boston host is the most exposed host in the private network, it is usually the most protected host. Generally, there are two or more Boston hosts in a network. One of the advantages of this architecture is that a public information server providing FTP, Telnet and HTTP services can be placed on the network segment between the screening router and the Boston host. If stronger security is desired, the Boston host can be configured to run proxy services that require both internal and external users to access the information server through the Boston host. In fact, one of the main functions of the Boston host is to act as a proxy server for various services including FTP, HTTP, Telnet, DNS and SMTP. Last type of firewall architecture is screened subnet firewall. The screened subnet firewall can be considered as an extension of the screened host firewall. Like the screened host firewall, it uses a screening router called the outer or external router and a Boston host. However, this firewall, which is also called the demilitarized zone DMZ, creates an extra layer of security by adding a perimeter network that further isolates the private network from the internet. The firewall defines a DMZ zone consisting of an outer router and an internal router, where the latter is placed closer to the private network than the outer network. The Boston host and the information server are also located within the DMZ as shown in figure. The DMZ can be considered as an isolated network between the private network and the internet. The outer router protects the network from external attacks by restricting access to system in the DMZ. It also blocks traffic to the internet from unauthorized sources in the private network. The internal router manages DMZ access to the private network by passing only traffic from the Boston host to the host in the private network that are not in the DMZ and vice versa. For an attack to reach any internal host located outside the DMZ, it must break through both routers. In addition, the architecture reveals only the DMZ network to the outside world and keeps the private network hidden. So, friends, this was about firewalls. In this lecture, we covered about introduction to firewalls, which was followed by types of firewalls. In the end, we discussed different architectures of firewall.